Hello, this is Clemmy Games, and welcome to a first look at Slayaway Camp, a puzzle game paying homage to 80s slasher flicks, developed by Blue Wizard Digital and released on Steam in October 2016. For disclosure, I received this game for free. The game is presented through a video store, with you controlling a different serial killer in each movie or level pack, starting with Skullface, who is also featured on the promotional material for this game. For a game which is being released around Halloween, I feel that Slayaway Camp is a fitting tribute to characters like Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees, and while I am not the biggest fan of horror movies or slasher flicks in general, I do have an appreciation for their cultural influence, and I do think that the theme works really well for a puzzle game. The objective in each level is to kill all the civilians and to get to the exit, which seems simple, but there is a twist to this. Firstly, this controls much like a sliding puzzle in that the killer will move in one direction until you come across a civilian or an environmental obstacle. The fact that killing a character does not cause your killer to move to the previously occupied spot is critical, and I have come across a number of puzzles which plays with this concept. Furthermore, your killer has the ability to influence the on-screen characters as well. Standing next to or killing someone next to another character will cause said character to scream and run off in the opposite direction, possibly into danger, which indirectly will cause the death as well. After killing all of the characters on screen, you then have to make your way to the exit, and it is possible to get stuck in an inescapable position, which means that your plan of attack must be well thought out. Luckily, there is a very easy to use rewind mechanic which allows you to undo your mistakes by simply pressing the R key with no penalties. Of course, in line with many other puzzle games, Slayaway Camp does gradually introduce additional mechanics which always keeps the puzzles fresh and interesting, including environmental hazards such as water, fire, or holes in the ground which will outright kill your character. We have bookcases which can be used to crush the victims, but these can also be cleverly used to create blocks on the ground in order to aid your navigation. We have telephones which can attract the attention of the victims, and even cops on the scene that will arrest you if you approach them from the front. Some levels may even impose a move limit on you, and all of these and more combine to make the puzzling experience in Slayaway Camp a fantastic one which I really enjoyed. Next, I want to talk about the presentation of the game. As I mentioned, each level pack follows a serial killer and a theme, all of which is presented very nicely with the video store format, with various graphical touches that bring up memories of VHS tapes. The voxely art style does also diminish the brutality of the kills in a good way, as I believe that the developer's intention were to pay homage but not get too explicit with the gore, and hence is a great decision in my opinion. On top of that, we do also have a currency system in the game. At the completion of each level, you are presented with a QuickTime event which sees a skull marker moving back and forth on a bar horizontally. Your objective is to click the mouse when the marker is in the red zone, which results in an extra kill and a reward of several coins. Coins here can be used to purchase hints for solving puzzles, as well as to unlock additional killers from a grab bag or to unlock various gore packs or fatalities. While this may seem free-to-play-ish at the outset, I never found it to be intrusive, but rather found it to be a nice way to regulate the number of hints that you were able to use. Furthermore, there is an additional Faces of Killed 3 video pack which just sees you playing these QuickTime events in quick succession, which is a way to earn currency, but more importantly, the audio feedback from the game whenever you successfully complete a kill is pretty satisfying in a video gamey kind of way, with exclamations of "Kill Crazy" and my personal favorite "Murderlicious". Finally, the information page on the game states that there are over 200 puzzles, which is a substantial chunk, especially when you take into account the deleted scenes levels, which are of a higher difficulty. The game also does not take itself too seriously, which is nice since it is more self-aware and goes all in on the campiness. This is exemplified by the option menu of all things, in which there is a slider to adjust the number of sliders in the options menu. I thought that this was a very clever move and it did make me smile. Overall, I felt that the great puzzles and great presentation makes Slayaway Camp a winner. Anyway, that will do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. Thanks again and I will see you in the next video.